not with Luis. Obviously, Tristan Shaun Gregson here with Tom the Boss Ross. I can talk to you about anything. Like, I just met you recently. I want to know what got you into the game, what makes you the great player you are today, and what your future plans are.
Hopefully win this Pro Tour is my future plan.
San Diego coming up right around now. I'm not sure when this is going to make the website, so you might have already won it. This might be beforehand. Yeah. We don't know yet.
Yeah, we just passed the Grand Prix a couple days ago. Oakland, that's where we met.
Yeah, you did pretty well in that tournament, right?
I was in contention for top eight going into the second last round. I lost that, and I lost my next round. Ended up 22nd. Okay.
Not bad. I mean, beating yours truly on the way there pretty much helped, definitely. And what were you playing in extended?
I was playing Zoo. Red, white, green. A little bit of blue that time. But usually stick to those colors.
You're a beatdown player?
Beatdown, a little bit control. I'm not full-on control kind of player.
It's nice to just have someone sitting in that chair who isn't constantly telling me about blue cards. Like, I swear to God, Luis never attacks ever.
If I play islands, it's usually just one island.
Just one? Yeah. Is that how many you were? Like, you weren't even running an island last weekend.
Oh, Hollow Fountain.
Oh, okay. Well, that kind of counts. So extended, like, I know I'm blown out over it. I'm done with it. I don't know about you. I mean,
yeah, I'm pretty sick of it right now.
Understood. We finally get to play with Worldwide cards in another format. I mean, sure, we saw some Jaces last weekend, but not much else. You think you've got a lot of World Wake that you're not, maybe not in your deck necessarily, you think you're going to see a lot of World Wake cards in the standard environment for the Pro Tour or following that?
Probably the rares. The blue ones have been talked about, hyped up a lot. The Kalsite Snapper, Treasure Hunt, the land that it looks top three. And yeah, Jace.
Pay no attention to that. So, I mean, the blue cards almost make their own deck. I mean, everyone thinks Halimar Depths, Snapper, all those cards kind of go into the same like deck, whatever it is. Stuff that's other than blue, though, I mean, is there anything out of World Wake that you see breaking the standard environment this weekend?
If you can find a place for them, I mean, cards like Abyssal Persecutor just need to find a home, but I can see them being really good. It's just, I mean, it's a Pro Tour. People will figure it out by then. People are smart out there, so.
So you don't have to give it away, but what might you be playing?
Probably some kind of Naya deck, maybe just white green, but some kind of beatdown thing.
Maybe some Elspeths, maybe some Baneslayers.
Maybe. I just don't want to play Jace.
You'd rather kill it than have to cast it?
I have a count of Jaces I've killed. See how high I can get.
And have you drafted much of the new set going into the Pro Tour?
No, not at all. I drafted tons of Zendikar, but I haven't got a chance to draft World Wake just yet. Hopefully we'll do that next couple days.
The people I talked to, surprisingly, it hasn't slowed down at all. It's almost the same format. I mean, red might have got a little bit better, kind of usurping black as the most popular color in draft. But I haven't seen much change either. I think this weekend is going to be quite a big deal to see the difference. So all that stuff's pretty boring to you. You've been working a lot on it. What I want to know from the boss is, I mean, what got you into the Magic? What has made you the player you are today?
I just had a good run last year. Just bounced from tournament to tournament, making some top eights. I took a break for a while. I originally got on the Pro Tour like a long time ago, like 9 years ago in 2001. But I've just been off and on, but I just been putting more time into it, I guess.
What got you like interested in the game? Like how were you introduced to it? And then
went to a store and bought a pack.
Just probably, how long, what'd you buy? What was the first thing you opened?
Ice Age, I think.
Ice Age?
Ice Age starter deck.
Sweet. And then, so that was really, you were introduced to the game, like, and what sets or like what cards really made you make the jump to competitive play?
I think Stripe Bears. Stripe Bears were the first card I started playing in tournaments. And I guess that's the point when I realized what card advantage was. And I started making my decks kind of more leaner and faster, working on mana bases, playing bigger, earlier creatures, learning about tempo. And yeah, just concepts like that, just flow as long, the more you play.
And so what deck did you play to get onto the Pro Tour? Like, what did you qualify with? Or did you get in there on rating?
Invasion Block Constructed. Played black, red, blue with like Factor Fictions and Urza's Rage, Nightscape Familiars. Back then the big decks were like Domain, like five color green stuff and white, red, blue, Lightning Angel Control, stuff like that.
Stuff like that. Now, you said you had a lot of success in the last year. What really brought you back and made you, I mean, like, get involved in the game to the point where you're succeeding as much as you are now?
Well, my friends dragged me along to Grand Prix Atlanta. I made day two and I faced Luis in round five, and he beat me when we were playing for top eight. Then he ended up winning the tournament. I ended up getting ninth. That gave me enough rating to get on the Pro Tour again. Well, I got qualified for Kyoto, but that was too far away. But I found the time to make it to Honolulu. And I don't know, I just did well there. If I did bad there, I probably wouldn't even be playing much Magic, but I did all right, so I stayed on. It is kind of a train. If you do well once, then you'll keep on going.
Now, Luis has always talked to me that it's like a player that succeeds doesn't really see any rewards from that until the following year. It's like if you play well in any given calendar year in Magic, you're not really going to see anything from it until the next year. So again, succeeding in 2009 has really paved the way for you to be able to play on the Pro Tour and more events in 2010. Right. And it's kind of the perpetual train, as it were, where it's like if you do well this year, you keep getting invited back, so on and so forth. So it's like if 2009 is your breakout year, 10 is the year where you really make it much more of an appearance, you think? I mean, already 22nd in the first major tournament for Magic from Wizards this year, going into this weekend in San Diego. And you're playing with the Channel Fireball team, as it were. You've got there all
pretty
the
cool guys.
The insight. Yeah, I mean, it's funny to watch them in the store right now, where it's like Luis is constantly playing the blue cards, and Brad's over there with
the Boros deck.
Yeah, he's there like lightning bolt goblin guy, and everyone's like, okay, this is pretty well defined. It's like you can test whatever you want, but it's funny to watch these guys like kind of naturally lean towards certain decks.
TV's over there trying crazy concepts out.
He walked up to me today and handed me like a pull list of cards he wanted for a deck, and I was like, I'm not going to ask any questions. I'm just going to go get these for you and see what happens.
He's been known to break some formats, though.
Well, I mean, I'm glad to see you in there in the mix. Like, having somebody that finally wants to play an aggressive deck and, like, trying to make, like, those kind of strategies work, like, I mean, again, thankfully Luis isn't here. I can use words like mid-range and not get, like, totally jumped on. Because, again, like, card advantage, cards, I mean, bring it all back to Stripe Bears. I mean, like, having stuff like that in the current standard environment, Ranger of Eos being, like, a 3-for-1. Yeah. I don't even know what you're playing. But, like, just cards like, playing a Johnny Vengeance, playing... aggressive cards that still cost 3, 4, maybe even 5 mana can be good in a deck, especially in the standard environment. And again, I'm very excited to see where that takes people. Like, maybe you're playing Tectonic Edge. I don't know. Like, is that good enough in your deck? Is it doing anything?
I don't know. 3 color is kind of tough to make it, but I try to fit it in somewhere. But it seems pretty good. The format seems a lot more shifting toward mid-range, in my opinion. Like, a lot of just some card advantage stuff, just trying to outplay people. It's not too fast, but it's not too slow. So.
Well, I mean, in my opinion, it's like you're seeing blue slowly creep back into the environment with this set. So an environment completely devoid of blue, it's probably going to be a pretty fast environment. Yeah. I mean, Jund dominated for such a long time. As soon as you make some at least viable control cards, you're going to see the format slow down a little bit. Mm-hmm. I mean, I've already heard of people still trying to make Jund work, and it's like they've cut the Bituminous Blasts out of their deck.
Yeah.
It's like, to me, that's like... The whole thing changes. Like, that's not even a Jund deck anymore.
Yeah, it's
like
a different deck.
It's like the bread and butter of, like, your cards are always 2-for-1s. As soon as you take that card out, like, everything changes. So it's very different to see, it's just not a very good card. It can't hit Sphinx, can't hit Snapper, can't hit, all the threats in certain decks.
Yeah, they took out Terminate, for sure. A lot of lists took out Terminate. But, yeah, Bituminous Blast is a card that catches you back up since some of the lands come into play tapped, and you don't have any 1-drop except for Lightning Bolt. So you gotta do something to catch back up on the tempo, and it's usually Bloodbraid Elf or Bituminous Blast or 2 dragons, Roommate Dragon.
All right, so my last question before we leave here: I know you haven't drafted much with World Wake, so I'm not gonna ask you how that's impacted Limited. But what's your favorite card out of the set? Like, just from what you've seen in testing or extended, or just, I mean, on your own flavor.
Favorite card? Probably Stoneforge Mystic.
A great answer. I already like it. I'm sorry. I'm just like, in my head, I'm picturing Luis saying something with a mana symbol with a island in it. Tell me a little bit what Stoneforge Mystic does for you.
What it does for me?
Yeah. Well, what makes you think it's the best card?
Well, first off, what it is, it costs one white and a colorless, and it's a 1/2, and you play it and you search your library for an equipment and put it in your hand. Then it has another ability where you can pay a white and a colorless and tap and put it into play. But it's just another card that gives you a lot of options.
The tutoring effect.
So it's another
right
toolbox
there.
Effect. Yeah. I always like cards like Nigh the Reliquary and like Ranger of Eos, because they're both powerful on their own, but if you build your deck right, you could have a lot of options to get yourself out of different situations. But I see that as a good card for block, and probably a good card for a while. More equipment comes out, the better card it gets.
Exciting.
Same way with Nigh the Reliquary. More lands come out, the better it gets.
Well, huh, who knows? Maybe those cards will be in your deck this weekend, maybe not. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. Excited to see you on the Pro Tour this weekend. Best of luck, Tom. I wish I was playing, but I'm glad at least you are, and someone out there is going to attack with some guys. So, again, this is Tristan Shaun Gregson signing off over at Channel Fireball. Thanks for watching, guys.